Determining bacterial susceptibility to antimicrobial compounds is an important part of patient management for treating infections. MIC is the gold standard for testing antimicrobial susceptibility. However, this diffusion method is an acceptable method because of its ease to perform and reproducible results. In this video, you will observe steps involved in performing antimicrobial susceptibility testing by Kirby-Bauer disc diffusion method.
For Kirby-Bauer disc diffusion testing, we need sterile swabs, 0.5 McFarland standard, black paper, antibiotic dispenser, forceps, molar Hinton agar plates, sterile saline, quality control organisms that include Staphylococcus aureus ATCC 25923. Other requirements include disposable loops or wire loops. And lastly, antibiotic discs. The antibiotics are selected on the basis of organisms and source of isolate, example blood, urine, etc. You should always pick well-isolated colonies of microorganisms with a sterile loop. From a non-selective agar with 18 to 24 hours of growth, after doing this, suspend the organisms in 2 ml sterile saline, preparing a smooth suspension. Adjust the turbidity equivalent to 0.5 McFarland index. This can be measured against McFarland standards or through spectrophotometry by measuring the optical density of the solution. Check the turbidity of test suspension using a turbidometer, or alternatively, turbidity can be adjusted by matching with 0.5 McFarland standard. This suspension should be used within 15 minutes of preparation. Preparation of Muller-Hinton agar plates. For non-fastidious organisms, Muller-Hinton agar is the recommended medium. For fastidious organism, Muller-Hinton agar supplemented with 5% defibrinated blood is recommended. Allow the plates to come to room temperature. If surface of agar is visibly wet, plates can be placed in an incubator for 10 to 15 minutes. Each plate is labeled with the specimen detail. Inoculating Muller-Hinton agar plates. Dip a sterile swab into the inoculum tube. Remove excess fluid by rotating the swab against the walls of the tube. Inoculate the surface of Muller-Hinton agar by streaking the swab thrice over the entire agar surface, rotating the plate approximately 60 degrees each time to ensure even distribution of inoculum. Then let the agar surface to dry. Placing the antibiotic discs. Take antibiotic discs out of the refrigerator and use within 30 minutes. Do not leave them out for longer. If using the disc dispenser, place the dispenser over the agar plate and press the plunger to dispense the discs. Alternatively, if a disc dispenser is not available, add discs one at a time using a forceps by firmly pressing the discs against the agar surface. Number of discs on a plate shouldn't be more than 6 discs on a standard 100 mm plate to avoid overlapping of zone sizes. Incubate at 35 to 37 degrees centigrade for 18 to 24 hours or according to organism's growth requirements. Measure the zone sizes to the nearest millimeters using a ruler. Viewing the back of the Petri plate, hold the plate on a non-reflecting surface with reflected light. Transmitted versus reflected light for different organisms. Record the zone of inhibition, which is the area around the disc showing no visible growth. If organism is growing up to the edges of antimicrobial disc, zone size is reported as 0 mm. Reporting and interpreting the results. Zone sizes are not same for all organisms, as same diameter may be susceptible for one antibiotic or microorganism but resistant for other. That is why it is important to follow the proper guidelines for result interpretations. Using the latest CLSI guidelines, determine the susceptibility to antimicrobial agents tested. Results of disc diffusion testing are reported as susceptible, intermediate, and resistant.